Do you remember singing Side by Side We Stand? Most likely you do, and probably remember some of the places where you sang it. That song conjures up so many memories for so many of us who were students at Adventist academies and colleges in the 1970s. While the song made a deep impression, few know the story of how it was written. Jeff Wood was a student at Pacific Union College when he wrote Side by Side. Let's listen to the story in his own words. It was the fall of 1970. I was a sophomore at Pacific Union College, toying with the idea of changing my theology major to something that didn't involve Greek. At the time, my good friend Clyde Morgan and I would often lead out in song services. One evening, we were asked to help out in a small student-initiated prayer meeting in the chapel. There we found 20 to 30 students gathered around the front of the chapel, and after leading out in a couple of songs, a short scripture was given by the student leader. Then we broke up into small groups for a season of prayer. Then we all stood in a small circle and sang, "Shall We Gather at the River?" What struck me about the meeting was that it was completely student-run. There was no worship credits given for attending. No signs were posted around a campus advertising it. No faculty member organizing it. The attendees were students who needed spiritual renewal and fellowship. The next week, there was well over 100 students. Looking around the circle, seeing the hope and commitment in the eyes of my fellow students was inspiring. We all felt that we were a part of a groundswell of spiritual renewal on the campus. It wasn't difficult to imagine this same scene playing out in heaven with Jesus at the head of the circle. I left the chapel that evening with an image locked in my heart. The next morning in my room in Granger Hall, I picked up my guitar and started strumming. The words were simple because the picture was already there. Side by side we stand. It was simply putting words to all that we had experienced and wished to experience. The music was, well, easy. 5 easy chords and a simple melody. I remember thinking people probably wouldn't like it much because it was in the key of C. But the first chord was an F major. About a half an hour later, it was done. I played it for Clyde, thinking if he liked it, we might do this in one of our little concerts sometime. He liked it. A lot. At the beginning of the next prayer meeting, Clyde told the group he wanted to teach them a new song, so he sang it for them. By the time he got to the second chorus, the whole group was singing as if they knew it. At the end of the meeting, instead of singing, "Shall We Gather at the River?" we sang Side by Side. The next week, so many students came that the circle encompassed the entire chapel twice. And as Side by Side was sung, everyone joined hands. About a year later, I was invited to see a singing group perform at Napa, California Church. The Heritage Singers ended their concert with a song that had the whole congregation standing side by side, joining hands together, and singing the little song I was blessed to have a part in writing. Now that's the story behind the beloved song. Jeff went on to become a movie producer, a film director, a musician, a writer. He directed and produced many of the Faith for Today Lifestyle magazine programs. He was instrumental in producing the movie Hell and Mr. Fudge. But even with many credits behind his name, the song Side by Side will always be remembered. Jeff passed away on October 11, 2018 in Angwin, California. And recently, Michael Spencer recorded more than 30 of Jeff's songs as a tribute to Jeff's ministry. The CD called Meet Me in Heaven, Remembering the Songs of Jeff Wood. The song Side by Side is definitely featured. Listen to a little now and let the memories put a smile on your face.